BBC London.
20 seconds and counting.
The roller coaster ride of her life. She's in the Wimbledon final.
12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4,
3, 2, 1.
Game on.
We have a liftoff. Tower cleared.
Wimbledon, man's semi-finals. A day of pressure, a day of passion, a day of nerve, when you need to hold serve. Two matches, there'll be agony, there'll be ecstasy, Djokovic. The machine, world number one, unbreakable, versus Del Potro, the tower, wounded, but dangerous. And there's Janowicz, the hammer, the unknown, versus Murray, the brave. He almost didn't make it, but he won the last point. Can he reach his second final? Time will tell. It will be tight. It will be tense. Let the battle commence.
Good afternoon. If you weren't excited before, you will be now. But Boris Becker knows all about the pressure of playing in a Wimbledon semi-final. Just four players remain, and by the end of today, there will be just two. Well, there is a very special atmosphere here at Wimbledon, as you would expect on men's semi-finals day. The Murray fans have been camping out for 2 days, many knowing that they won't even get near centre court, but happy to cheer him on from the hill in front of the big screen. It's men's semi-finals day, and although Wimbledon has been full of surprises, the two matches on offer really do have a fascinating contrast of styles. We've got the world number one, Novak Djokovic, first on court. He's through to his 13th consecutive Grand Slam semi-final, up against Juan Martín Del Potro. Will the knee injury be an issue today? It'll certainly be severely tested by the world number one. 18 months ago, Jerzy Janowicz was ranked 222 in the world. Now he's 22 and climbing, and he's hit 94 aces en route to the last four. But then Andy has a great return and knows how to use it. So those are the two matches that we are looking forward to. Andy's been warming up today here in the sunshine. We thought his Wimbledon was over at two sets down to Verdasco. Somehow he found a way to win. Murray has his supporters here and has asked them to be loud and proud, as they were in the latter stages of his epic comeback on Wednesday. But the Polish fans are here as well to cheer on this man, the 22-year-old, in his first Grand Slam semi-final. And when the gates opened at 10:30, if you couldn't get to centre court, there was the charge to the hill for everyone trying to take their place, have a picnic and enjoy the tennis. So, as you can see, Henman Hill is packed, but just on the players' balcony here, well, we can see some from the Murray camp. Judy Murray is enjoying lunch. Well, I'm not sure how much she'll probably be enjoying it. I'm sure she's nervous. And there's Andy's girlfriend, Kim Sears, making her way and, oh, bumping into Ross Hutchins, his best friend, and Ross's father, Paul Hutchins, former player and Davis Cup captain. Ross diagnosed with Hodgkin's lymphoma last year, had his last chemotherapy during Queen's Club. We wish him well, and he'll be in Murray's corner for the second semi-final today. So those are the scenes at Wimbledon today, and Carol said she was going to head out to try and watch some tennis. I'm not sure where she is, but before she watches the tennis, hopefully she'll tell us how sunny it's going to be.
Well, it is gorgeous at the moment, Sue. I'm on Hemming Hill watching the big screen along with everybody else. And to use my own word, it is scorchio out here today. Temperatures already way up into the 20 Celsius, and they're going to continue like that as we go through the afternoon. There's hardly a cloud in the sky. It's beautiful. Light winds as well, temperatures up to about 25, 26 as we go through the afternoon and also into the evening. So the UV levels are high, as indeed is the pollen level. In fact, the pollen level is very high. And some good news on the horizon as we go through the next couple of days, right to the end of the championships. The weather is going to stay fine, and if anything, it's going to get warmer, even hot soon. So I hope you've got your sunblock with you.
When I'm out there, I'll certainly take it, Carol. Great news, and the players will love it after the cold and windy weather that we've experienced over the past few weeks. But Murray and Jarovic, they will potentially offer a tea time thriller for us today, second on centre. First up, though, it is the best player on the planet.
BBC Sport presents from the famous lawns of Wimbledon. He's travelled from another galaxy, across an ocean of stars. He has arrived to change planet Earth. He walks among us, but he is not like us. He is not human. He is out of this world. Part man, part supreme being. He will never give in. Novak Djokovic is Man of Steel.
If I was Del Potro, I'd be worried after that. But he's on court up against Djokovic. He is a man of steel physically and mentally. But here we join it with Del Potro serving to try and stay in this first set at 4-5. Let's